before we start, please like, share and subscribe Mom Life for all the latest videos on real life parenting tips. Hi parents! So in my last video, I had shown few creative stuff done by the new generation kids. And in this video, I'm going to show you more interesting stuff done by the few younger kids. So these activities actually are not restricted to kids' age, and I bet that you will also be tempted to try them. So let's see four very interesting ways to keep kids above 7 years till the age of 70 also busy and engage their mind intellectually and competitively. So first is best out of waste, a decoupé bottle. So beautiful, elegant. So let's see how she has made these beautiful bottles, enhancing the charm of her house and participating in the decor at the age of 9 years only.
Hello everyone, today we are going to make a decoupage bottle which is going to come out like this. And for most importantly, you need a bottle, a clean glass bottle. And these are the papers you are going to use. These are the chalk colors. This will stick in the glass easily. And this is Mod Podge. You need this brush and dip on it. And then put it so that these papers stick easily. And you need these toothpicks to cut this thing. Like for example, I dip it in the water and then trace it and then cut it from the toothpick. Awesome diamonds. This is used to decorate it like this. I'm using different colors to get the different shapes. So let's get dabbing. So now let's do it with a brush. The more you take, it takes more time to dry. Take pink more so that the texture comes real, because there is pink more at the flower I've used. Try to spread it all over the bottle. The sunlight texture I've used from the sponge. For the cap I've used color with golden shade. Let me show you by cutting this hole. Look, it's fully wet. And then I'm putting it here. And for cutting this, you need a toothpick and drag it like this really carefully for the texture effect. We are doing this and not using scissors. Look how pretty it's looking from the down. Now I'm continuing it with this. See how nice the texture is coming. Now let's take the other one. It's happening. And little here. Twist and turn and round and around. So this is how it should look from up. It's a little tough putting it between these two things because it have a lot of crumbs. So this is how it's coming out. Guess why I'm putting this Mod Podge tube above these things? The answer is simple, because the paper below is really thin, so it will tear off if you just stick it like that. So that's why you need to put it from up above it. Now let's go on with the next. So I'm going to put it here. Now I'm putting the Mod Podge. Look how it came out. Motis I'm attaching here. A little bit more pink there and a little white here. So here I've completed this bottle. So how do you think it's looking?
Second is use of an MIT made, which is a US university ranked as number one for engineering. MIT based platform or app called Scratch, which many people doesn't know is available for free on internet and which helps in making games, storyboards, etc. So let's see what she has made using this platform at the age of 9 years only. Oh my god, genius, na?
Hello everyone, my name is Risha and I'm going to teach you how to utilize your time while during lockdown. I know you've all been playing games on mobiles, laptops or any other things. But have you ever thought once that who creates them? This is how I'm going to teach you how to create games and utilize your time during lockdown.
Yes, so as I was talking about games, I've created this many games. And my favorite one is Flappy Bird. I've recreated Flappy Bird with you. I've been using Scratch as a platform, so it's very easy. You just need the coding, brains, and imagination. So this is how you lose, and let's see. So this is my favorite game, recreating Flappy Bird.
Download Scratch and start making small games like me.
So I will quickly show you a demo of how to make a game called Dog Chasing Ball. So open the Scratch website and create your login first. For beginners, on the first page, you can find tutorials to create a game, animation or story. Let me quickly show you how do I created my dog chasing ball game. So first thing, I will select my objects for the game, that is dog and ball. I haven't selected a background, but there are three backgrounds available in Scratch which you can use. Now I will define the arrow keys on my keyboard to have left, right, up and down movement of the dog. For that, I clicked orange circle on the left named events, which gave me all these orange bars on the left side of the panel. I pressed the drop down and selected right arrow. Then I pressed motion, that is blue circle. I selected change x by 10. Now this has defined that when I press right key, my dog will move to the right. Similarly, I defined left up and down key. Please note, for left and up and down, I will assign the value minus 10. So our controls are done. Now we will define the ball's motion. I want the ball to move randomly in the box so that the user needs to move the keys to chase the ball, and once he reaches, the game stops. So I take the first thing as green flag, which signifies the start of game. Then I click brown circle called control, from where I picked up forever, as my ball needs to move forever. So it looks simple, but it ain't that simple. Try out by yourself, you will make it more interesting.
So third is sketching. Just a pencil and a paper and let the imagination roll out. To develop an interest in the creative art, one can encourage their child at a very early age to draw their favorite characters like he has done. Drawing an entire face is very difficult since it has got a lot of features in it. But since his parents supported and encouraged him at a very early age, so you can see that he is able to make an exact sketch of a person. You can sit and he can make an exact replica of your face right there. Isn't it interesting? Where she is making an entire wall herself with the help of modern art called doodle art, which is very in these days. So you can see that this generation kids can literally do anything. So here she has used Harry Potter theme and its characters such as a wand, their hat, etc. and so many daily things also.
Hey guys, today I'm finally going to turn my boring ball into something interesting, and that is doodles. So for this, I'll be needing only four simple things, and that is an eraser, 2B pencil, permanent marker, and a scale. As because I'm a die-hard fan of Harry Potter, I am working on Harry Potter theme. You can choose any theme, Avengers, cartoons, and even you can even put random pictures, random drawings in it, like TV and all. So let's start drawing. You can draw first of all some rough sketches, and then you can when you outline it with a permanent marker, you can modify it or you can improve it. Now
second step is we will trace these drawings with a permanent marker, and I have chosen this bold one. So let's trace.
Write in the comment section what you think about these activities or what other activities your kids has been doing which can help other parents too. And if you like the video, please give a thumbs up and please subscribe to my channel Mom Life for all the latest videos on smart and real life parenting tips. Thanks for watching and see you guys with some other video next week. Till then, happy parenting. Bye bye. But please like, share and subscribe before